Hi, I'm Stu from Hivemind Automation and welcome back to The Hive. In this quick tips video, we're going to be taking a deep dive into the Home Assistant LIFX integration, so it might not be as quick as I'd anticipated. We'll take a look at integrating devices into Home Assistant, and we'll dig into how we can then make use of Home Assistant to interact with our lights, especially in some automations. So while I roll the intro, why don't you take a moment to subscribe? And if you hit the bell icon, you'll get notified when I release new videos each week. While you're at it, if you like what I do here and you want to support the channel, there's some affiliate links to smart home gadgets that you can buy for your very own smart home and support the channel at the same time, or you can support the channel directly through my Buy Me a Coffee link. Of course, any affiliate links and my Buy Me a Coffee link can all be found on my website, hivemindautomation.com.au. With all of that out of the way, let's get started. So we've looked at plenty of LIFX gear over the years on the channel, and as you might have picked up, I'm a big fan of LIFX as a brand. The build quality of their devices is always excellent. They have the broadest white balance range of any smart light manufacturer. And the fact that they're a Melbourne-based company gives me just a little bit of a sense of hometown pride as well. As we'll see shortly, the LIFX integration into Home Assistant could not be simpler. And we also then get access to a handful of additional service calls that we can use to add various lighting effects into some of our automations if we want to go down that path as well. So let's kick things off with the outrageously simple Home Assistant LIFX integration. Over on my demo instance, I'm going to head over to Settings, and then Devices and Services. And then we've got the auto discovery section here where we see the bathroom light and my neon flex that are discoverable. Starting with the bathroom light, I'll click on configure. On this prompt to confirm, I'll click submit. It's figured out already that it's in the bathroom, so we don't need to change anything here, and we just click submit. I'll quickly run through the same thing for the neon flex. Configure, submit, submit. When we scroll all the way down in our devices and services and find our LIFX integration, we see we've got the discovered devices in the list here, but I really want to look specifically at the neon flex and the bathroom light. For the bathroom light, we'll drill in and I'll quickly test out the responsiveness of on and off, which is really nice and quick. It's always very responsive. Clicking the identify button here makes the light flash a couple of times so we can figure out which one it is if we have multiple lights in an array. Because this happens to be a LIFX Plus light, which has night vision infrared LEDs to assist night vision on cameras, we've got this infrared brightness drop down here. And so we can set the brightness of the infrared LEDs when the light itself is turned off. There's a restart button here, which does what it says on the box. It reboots the light bulb. And in the diagnostics section here, we've got this RSSI sensor. This is normally hidden, but because I've had this light paired before and enabled this sensor, it's remembered that this light is here. And some of the data has also been remembered. This RSSI sensor displays the wireless signal strength, and we can use that to help figure out connectivity issues and troubleshoot those. Drilling into the light controls, we see that we've got full control of that super wide white temperature range. And heading to the color picker, we have access to the full spectrum of colors available from the light. And as always, the output from these is rich and gorgeous. We have this effect dropdown at the bottom, which has items like effect underscore color loop, effect underscore pulse, and effect underscore stop. And we'll take a look at those in more detail, but you'll notice if we choose them here, they don't really do very much. Color loop doesn't do much at all, at least it's not really noticeable. I have a feeling if we left this to run for a while, we might notice it slowly fading through some colors. The effect underscore pulse kind of does something, but it only does it once, which isn't particularly exciting. And then we've got effect underscore stop, which is there to stop any effects that are running on the device. In order to use these effects effectively, pun intended, we'll test them out in developer tools, and then services. You'd normally use this call service idea inside an automation, but the developer tools section lets us send these service calls ad hoc to test out how they're going to look. I'll end up adding one of these service calls to an automation a bit later on. In the service dropdown, we can either type in lifx.effect_colorloop or select lifx:colorloop effect. I'm only going to change my brightness to 100%, the period to 2 seconds, otherwise it'll be 60 seconds before we can really see the effect moving, which might be nice in some cases, but for now I want to keep it short. I'll leave the other parameters alone and then click call service. And straight away, when we called the service, the light began cycling through some colors. I'll head back to settings, devices and services, and I'll find my LIFX integration, open up the bathroom light, and in effects, I'll select effect_stop, and the light reverts back to the setting that it was on before we called the color loop service. Dropping back out to the LIFX device list, I'll drill into the neon flex now, and we see many of the same controls, and testing them out again, it's super responsive for the power, the same identify button and restart button. But this time, instead of the infrared brightness dropdown, we've got a theme dropdown. And some of these themes do line up to the themes that we saw in the LIFX app, but not all of them. We definitely don't have as many in the Home Assistant integration. And in some cases, the names are just a little bit different. For example, Proud instead of Pride. I'm going to show hidden indices in diagnostics, and I'll enable this RSSI entity. I personally think that it's helpful to have this data. Drilling into the light controls again, they're mostly the same, except in the effects dropdown, we have this effect move option. And if we click that, we get the effect of the different colors in the strip moving along the strip, as the name suggests that it would do. With that move effect running, if I drop back out and change the theme to peaceful, the move effect is still running along the strip there. Heading back over to the developer tools, we'll try adding the neon flex to our target for the color loop effect. And then when I call the service, both LIFX lights run through the color loop. While I didn't expect them to be in perfect sync, it's worth knowing that if you have multiple lights that you want to run a color loop effect on, they may not be in sync, so you might not quite get the effect that you're looking for. With both the neon flex and the bathroom light running the color loop effect, I can now find lifx.effect_stop in the call service, select both lights as our target entities and call the service. And both lights end up reverting back to where they were before we ran that color loop effect. Looking more at some of these LIFX specific effects, we see that we've got flame effect listed here, and it does explicitly say that it's used for the LIFX tile or the LIFX candle. And if I choose this effect and target the neon flex and hit call service, nothing happens. It's worth mentioning in the LIFX app though, there is a flame effect. So while I can enable the flame effect in the LIFX app, on the neon flex, it doesn't work using the Home Assistant integration right now. I took a quick look at the LIFX API documentation, and it actually only mentions the LIFX tiles. So I think that this might just be a limitation of the API right now, not the Home Assistant integration. If we look at the LIFX morph effect, target the neon flex and call the service again, nothing changes. And again, the API documentation only refers to the tiles, and the Home Assistant page refers only to tiles and candle. Moving on to the move effect, and we saw this one working before, so we know that it works. But inside this call service, we do get some more options. We can target the neon flex. We can set our speed and our direction either left or right. And then we can also choose a theme for the move effect. It is worth noting though, that not all the themes in this list seem to work. When I called the theme with Independence Day, it returned an error telling us that the theme needed to be one of the ones listed in the error. Choosing powerful and hitting call service worked for me. Cheerful and call service also worked. And then warming and call service worked again. And if we go over to the LIFX app, we end up seeing that the move effect shows up in the app. I did notice there's a bit of a delay between when the service call hits the device and when it gets reflected in the app, but it does show up after a few moments. I'll grab lifx.effect_stop, target both lights, and call the service. The last service call I want to look at here is lifx.effect_pulse, or the LIFX pulse effect from the dropdown. I'll target both lights. We do have a few different modes for this pulse effect. Blink just swaps between the current setting and what you select without any kind of ramping, so it can be a bit jarring. Breathe, which is what we're going to use here, gently ramps between the current setting and the target setting. I found ping interesting because it flashes the target color only for a fraction of a second at each interval that you define as your period. Strobe ends up turning the current setting off before then strobing between off and on in the target color that you've chosen and for the period that you've chosen. So if it's 1 second, it'll be on for a second, off for a second, etc. And solid just changes the light to that particular setting for the full duration of the effect. So in the case of solid, if you happen to have your setting at 1 second period for 20 cycles, it will go to that setting for 20 seconds. As I say, we'll set this to breathe. I'll set our brightness to 100%. And in color name here, I'm going to type in orange or lowercase. I'll leave the period at 1 second. And for cycles, I'm going to set this to 200. And I'll make sure that this power on variable is turned on. That just means that if the light is currently off, it's going to power it on to run the effect. And then it'll return back to off when the effect completes. And we'll see that when we call this service and it kicks both lights off and they should be pulsing 200 times. And as you see, you'll notice that in between the pulses of orange, the neon flex still has its prior setting. And this would be true of all of the LIFX lights that are running this pulse effect. So if it were blue, it would flash to the orange for the period of the pulse effect and then back to blue. So that's the pulse effect. Now, again, I'll quickly call stop effect on both lights here so that we don't have to watch all 200 of those pulses. And I'm going to call a light.turnoff on both devices as well. I'm going to head out now over to settings, automations and scenes, and I'll grab this doorbell flash ambient light automation that I set up during testing, and I'm going to make some changes to it. The trigger is when a Zigbee button is pressed or long pressed, and then we've got two actions running in parallel here. Like with the developer tools, we're calling the LIFX pulse effect on the neon flex. I'll also add the bathroom light here. At the moment, I've got this automation set up to pulse green, but I'll quickly change that over to blue. And we're going to pulse 20 times at 1 second intervals, and the power on flag is set to on. Now, if I press the Zigbee button that I've configured for this automation, we get the blue bar in Home Assistant showing that it was triggered, and the neon flex and the bathroom light all start pulsing a blue color. So that's a deep dive on the Home Assistant LIFX integration. As you've seen, the setup is super easy, and when it's done, we get access to call some of the effects that we see inside the LIFX app, and some that we didn't have access to before either. Being able to add some effect lighting to our Home Assistant automations here is awesome, though I am a little disappointed that we don't have access to all of the effects, and some of the themes seem to be either poorly named or just plain not available. Like in the demo, we can flash our lights green when someone rings the doorbell, for instance, which would be great if we're working away with headphones on and can't hear the doorbell. It'd also be great as an accessibility feature, say if you're hard of hearing. Because it's using an easy to change light bulb and a wireless button, you don't need an electrician to set it up for you, making it rental friendly. I also like to use this pulse effect when the alarm goes off to pulse the lights red. You could set up some lights to flash red and some to flash blue and mimic kind of a police car vibe. Or because they pulse between the color that you choose and the color that they were already set to, you could set your automation up to set them to either red or blue and then pulse the lights the opposite color in that sequence if you wanted to go down that path to get a similar effect. Let me know how you use the LIFX integration and effects in your smart home in the comments section down below. That's all we have for this video, and I do hope that it helped you in your smart home journey. Be sure to drop a comment down below with a home automation idea you'd like to see me cover in a future video. And don't forget to follow Hivemind Automation on Instagram and Facebook. If you like this video, hit the thumbs up button down below to give it a like. And if you're not already subscribed, now's a great time to change that. While you're at it, if you hit the bell icon, you'll get a notification when I release new videos each week. Lastly, if you enjoy what I do here and you want to support the channel, there's a Buy Me a Coffee link in the video description. Any contribution you make through Buy Me a Coffee does get put towards making more and hopefully better content for you to enjoy. Don't forget to check out my website, hivemindautomation.com.au. Thanks so much for watching. I'm Stu from Hivemind Automation, and I'm looking forward to seeing you next time. Bye for now.